Hi, and welcome to class. One of the things we're going to be doing this year is going to be talking about coordinate planes and linear functions and how to actually graph linear functions on coordinate planes. This is going to be a big part of the 8th grade material, so before we get into it too deep, we will need to go over what some basic parts of the coordinate plane are. The first thing that we need to talk about is what the origin actually is. The origin is this little dot that's going to be right here in the middle of the graph. The reason that the origin is going to be so important is because we want to determine how far away from the origin we're actually going to go and in which direction. If we end up going to the left and the right, we're going to call that the y-axis. The y-axis starts from left to right. All of the positive numbers for the y-axis are going to be plotted to the right side of the graph, whereas all of the negative numbers are going to be to the left of the origin. So when we talk about the x-axis, we need to know that the positive numbers are on the right side, and the negative numbers are going to be the left side of the origin. The other axis we're going to be talking about is the y-axis. The y-axis is your vertical axis that goes up and down. The positive numbers for your vertical y-axis are going to be all above the origin, whereas the negatives are all going to be below the origin. So again, just knowing where the origin is will help us to determine where on the graph we're going to put our points. When we start dealing in linear functions, however, what we're going to be looking at are different types of lines. Suppose we were to plot this line right here on the coordinate plane. There are certain attributes of this line that will tell us whether the line is a linear function or not. One of the things we're going to be looking at is this right here. The first attribute is that it must be a straight line. When we talk about straight lines for linear functions, what we mean is that it starts down here in the bottom and it continues in the same way throughout the entire graph. It doesn't change the direction that it moves. So if the graph begins the one way and continues in the same direction, and it is a straight line, it could be a linear function. The second thing that we're going to be looking at is this right here. It must have a constant pattern. We're going to be focusing on the idea of a pattern a lot in the 8th grade. One of the things we need to know is, does this have the same pattern? Can we continue on in the same way over and over again to predict where this line is going to go? Which leads us to the third thing. The third attribute is going to be that it can predict future events. Am I able to draw a point that is past where the line is already plotted to determine what the coordinates of that new point would be? So can I continue the pattern on and predict where the future coordinate is going to be for this graph? The last thing that we're going to be able to do with linear functions is write equations for them. Because if we're able to continue the pattern on, we know what the future events will be and we can predict it, and we do know that it's going to be in a straight line, then what we can do is we can take that information and write an equation for it, which will just help us come up with a shorthand way of determining what some of the information on this line is going to be. A linear function must have all four of these attributes for it to be linear, and we will start to plot them all on a coordinate plane.